a metal of diameter 2 mm. See, diameter is equal to 2 mm. It means radius is equal to diameter divided by 2 is equal to 2 mm divided by 2. So, radius is equal to 1 mm or 10 to the power minus 3 meter. This is radius. And it has a length of 100 meter. Length of 100 meter has a resistance of 0. See, resistance, we call it as R1, is equal to 0.5475 at T1 is equal to 20 degree centigrade. Then R2 is equal to 0.805 ohm at T2 is equal to 150 degree centigrade. It means the temperature is raised from 20 to 150, so we can keep as a reference temperature. So change in temperature is equal to 150 minus 20 is equal to 130 degree centigrade. This is a change in temperature. So first, find the temperature coefficient of resistance. We know temperature, raised temperature is equal to temperature at a reference. We call it as R naught, at reference temperature, into 1 plus alpha into delta T. Or we can say R is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha into delta T. Sorry, R naught plus R naught. Or we can call it as R naught alpha delta T is equal to R minus R naught. This is increased temperature, this is reference temperature, resistance at reference temperature, this is increased temperature at increased temperature, increased resistance at increased temperature. R alpha is equal to delta T, alpha is equal to R minus R naught into R naught into delta T is equal to R minus R naught into R naught. Delta T is equal to raised temperature, that is T2 minus T1, T2 minus T1, this is, we can call it as T2, and this we call it as T1. What is R? R is the reference, because it is raised from 20 degree to 150 degrees, so this we can call it as R1. So this can be written as R 2 minus R is equal, this can be called as R, this can be called as reference. So R2 minus R1 divided by R0, R0 is equal to R1 into R1 into, so here we miss R0 into delta T, R0 into T2 minus T1. T2 minus T1, R0. Okay, therefore alpha is equal to R2. R2 is equal to 0.805 minus 0.805 R2 is, and R1 is equal to 0.5475 divided by R1. R1 is equal to 0.5475 into change in temperature. Change in temperature is equal to T2 minus T1. 150 minus 20. So alpha is equal to 8.05. This comes out to be 5.5725 divided by 5.575. This is equal to 0.5 4.75 into 130. And division and calculating this one, 0.275 divided by, this is a calculated value is, calculated value is 0.47032, this value, divided by 130. And again, the calculated value for this one is equal to 0.00 into 3618, or it can be 123, or it can be written as 3.6 into 123 minus 3 per degree centigrade minus 1, so alpha. Now, first question we have already solved, and alpha is equal to this much. Second question, find the resistance at 0 degree temperature. Resistance at 0 degree centigrade. 0 degree centigrade. See, this is the conductor, same conductor. Same conductor means alpha is same. It is at 0 degree centigrade and its resistance will be R naught. So it is from 0 degree, it is rise to how much? It is rise to 20 degree, and its R1 is equal to this much, this value. Now same conductor is rise to 150 degree centigrade and its resistance is R2. We know the formula. R is equal to resistance is equal to R naught into 1 plus alpha into delta T. For this case, delta T is from 150 minus 0 is equal to 150 degree centigrade. It is delta T1. Now for this one, delta T2, let us call it as delta T2, and delta T1 is 20 minus 0, that is equal to 20 degree centigrade. And we can write R1 is equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha delta T1. R2 is equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha delta T2. Why? Because from R0, the temperature is raised to 150 degree centigrade, and R2, we got it R2 this much. And from same 0 degree centigrade, it is raised to 20 degree, and the resistance, new resistance after rising the temperature is R1. So we can use R0 will not change because R0 is same in both the equation, because this is delta T1, this is delta T, accordingly it varies R1 and R2. Because of this, this varies, but this does not vary. So we will take this equation. What this equation? See, R1 is equal to R0 into 1 plus alpha delta T1. So R1, what is R1? So we have to find out R0. R0 is equal to R1 divided by 1 plus alpha into delta T1. From this equation, we got this. R1 is equal to R0, 1 to delta T1. So delta T1 we know, this is delta T2. We are using this equation R1, so we can write R1. What is R1? R0. Therefore, R0 is equal to, R1 is equal to 0.5475 ohm divided by 1 plus alpha is same because conductor is same. So whether it is temperature only, variation of temperature from 0 degree to 20 degree, from 0 degree to 150 degree. So alpha already we got 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3, this is R0, into delta T1. What is delta T1? Delta T1 is equal to 20 degree. So this is equal to 0.5475 into 1 plus 20 into 3.6 is equal to 20 into 3.6, 36 into 72, that is 72 into 10 to the power minus 3, which is equal to 0.5475. 72, what is 72? 72 into 10 to the power minus 3 is equal to 0.72, and 1 plus divided by 0 point, this is become 1 plus 0.072, which is equal to 0.545 and divided by 1.072. This is R naught, the calculated value for R naught, the calculated value for R naught is equal to 0.5107. So the value of R naught is equal to 0.5107 ohm. So R naught is equal to, we can write R naught is equal to 0.517 ohm. From on rising 20 degree, then it becomes R1, on rising to 150 degree, it becomes R2. So this is the answer. The second question is already, we find out the resistance at 0 degree centigrade. That resistance at 0 degree centigrade is equal to 0.517 ohm. Now the third question is resistivity at 0 degree and 20 degree. Resistivity at 0 degree centigrade. First we will find out resistivity at 0 degree centigrade. We will find out. See, we know resistance is equal to resistivity into length by area, or resistivity is equal to R into A by L. Now we want to find out resistivity at 0 degree centigrade is equal to R0 into A into L. Area and L assumed to be not changing. Okay, so resistivity at 0 degree is equal to resistivity at 0 degree centigrade, resistance at 0 degree centigrade 0.517 into, and area, what is the area? Area is equal to pi r square into r. R is equal to 10 to the power minus 3 whole square, because the radius is 10 to the power minus 3 in meter, it should be in meter, divided pi r square divided by length. Length is given 100 meter. So this becomes 0.57, we can write is 517 multiplied by 1000, here also multiplied by 1000 into 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 6 divided by 10 to the power 2. So this is 3 plus 2. So this is equal to 517 into 3.14 into, this is 3 plus 4, 5, into 10 to the power minus 6 minus 5. So this will become, so resistivity at 0 degree temperature is equal to 517 into 3.14 into 10 to the power minus 11. Everything has gone on the top of this, which is calculated value is equal to 1.623.38 into 10 to the power minus 11. If you reduce it, 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8. 10 to the power minus 8. What is the unit? Since this is rho is equal to density is equal to, this is in ohm, this is in meter square, divided by meter is equal to ohm meter. So we can write the unit as ohm meter. So this is the resistivity at 0 degree. Resistivity at 0 degree is equal to 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8 ohm meter. So resistivity at 0 degree centigrade. Resistivity at 0 degree centigrade is equal to 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8. So resistivity at 20 degree centigrade. See, resistivity at 20 degree centigrade means it is from 0 degree, it is raised to 20 degree centigrade. 20, it means delta T. Delta T is equal to 20 minus 0 is equal to 20 degree centigrade. Delta. As it is, we know the formula resistivity at any temperature, any raised temperature is equal to resistivity at 0 degree temperature into 1 plus alpha into delta T. Delta T is equal to 20 degree centigrade, alpha is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3, and resistivity at 0 degree centigrade is equal to 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8. So resistivity at 20 degree centigrade is equal to resistivity at 0, 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8 into 1 plus alpha is equal to 3.6 into 10 to the power minus 3 into delta T. Into delta T is equal to into 20. Delta T is equal to 20. This is equal to, we can 1.623 into 10 to the power minus 8. See, this is 20 into 3.6 is 72. This is become 72. 72 into 10 to the power minus 3 is equal to 0.072 plus 1. Plus 1, so this is 1.072, so this is 0.1.072, this is equal to 0.172, 1.072, so 1.6 into 6 into, so when we multiply both, this becomes 1.7152 into 10 to the power minus 8. This is the calculated value. So density resistivity at 20 degree is the calculated value. 1.72 into, or we can write 1.72 into 10 to the power minus 8. Resistivity is ohm meter.